On my next vacation, I'm going to Mars. It's gonna be awesome. Of course, if you've been to Mars, you know the problem. It takes forever to get there. We're talking 200 days. That's a long trip. Now, they won't let me just do whatever I want to. I got jobs to do. I got to monitor equipment, all sorts of stuff. But they do let me take one break each day. Unfortunately, there's not a whole lot to do when you're on a spaceship on your way to Mars. I mean, you can't even surf the internet. You ever tried using the internet from space? I mean, if you're in Earth orbit, you're okay. It's like having satellite internet. It's a little slow, but you can get by. But once you get like halfway on the way to Mars, you're like, click. It takes 10 minutes for the signal to get to Earth, 10 minutes to get back to you. Ah, forget about it. It's worse than dial-up. If you want the internet in space, you've got to bring the whole internet with you. They won't let me take the internet with me, so no internet in space. All I've got are video games and movies. And I have a bunch of restrictions, too. Video games cost $8 each. Movies cost $3 each. They're only going to let me have $1,200 to spend on my entertainment. Totally ridiculous. It's going to cost more than that every second to send me off to Mars, but that's my budget. Next, I have a memory restriction. Video games only take up 0.2 gigs each. Each movie takes up 0.8 gigs. They're only going to give me this little tiny hard drive, 130 gigs. Completely ridiculous. Now, on my break, I get to play one video game or I get to watch one movie. One or the other, can't do both. And I'm only going to play each video game once. I'm not going to play over and over and over again. I'm only going to watch each movie once. Not going to do that over and over again. Each video game takes 4 hours. So if I choose a video game on a given day, I've got a 4-hour break. I get to play that whole game beginning to end. Movie, I choose a movie. I get a 2-hour break. Just watch the movie, then back to work. So you know what my goal is. My goal is to chew up as much time as I possibly can on my breaks. Now, I have to figure out how many video games and how many movies I should get to bring on this trip to chew up as much break time on video games and movies as I can. Well, it's a pretty wordy problem. You know what we're going to do first. We're going to assign some variables. Turn all these words into some math. Start off with letting X be the number of video games and Y be the number of movies. And of course, we know right away that X and Y have to be non-negative. Can't have a negative number of video games. Now we've got all these other restrictions here. I got my one break per day restriction. That means total number of video games I watch, total number of movies I watch, that has to be less than or equal to 200. I add these two together because I get to do one each, one of each. I can't do both. I've got to do one of each on any given day. I've got 200 days. Next, I have my money restriction. I'm going to spend 8x on video games. I'm going to spend 3y on movies. Total amount of money I spend has to be no more than $1,200. Finally, I got the memory restriction here. I'm going to use 0.2 times x gigs on the video games, 0.8 times y on the movies, and that sum has to be less than or equal to 130. The total amount of memory I've got on my itty-bitty hard drive. Now, here's my goal. My goal is to maximize the amount of time I waste on my breaks. I want to maximize 4x, which is the amount of time I play video games, plus 2y, the amount of time I spend watching movies. So, how in the world am I going to do this? I need to maximize, I need to make 4x plus 2y as large as I possibly can, as long as x and y satisfy all of these restrictions. Those restrictions are kind of hard for me to think about when they're in this form, but I did just learn how to graph inequalities. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a picture of all these inequalities. I'm going to graph them all, because I often think a lot better in pictures than I do in algebra. So I'm going to draw pictures of all this algebra over here. I'm going to start off with this restriction right here. I'm going to color this one yellow. This x plus 2y is less than or equal to 200. We'll start off by graphing the line x plus y equals 200. That'll just go through 200, 0, and 0, 200. So there's our line. And then I want x plus y to be less than or equal to 200. So I've got to shade the region that's below that line. And these are all the points where x plus y is less than or equal to 200. So that takes care of that restriction. I'm going to go on to the next one. New restriction. We need a new color. We're going to color this one red. And again, I'm going to start off by graphing the line. 8x plus 3y equals 1200. Now, if I let y be 0, I'll have 8x equals 1200. Divide by 8 tells me x is 150. So I have a point. Now, if I just find the slope, I can use draw a line through that point with that slope. If I subtract 8x from both sides and then divide by 3, I'll have a negative 8/3 x. And that'll give me a slope of negative 8/3. So it's a negative slope. That means it's sloping down. And because it's negative 8/3, negative 2 2/3, we know it's a little steep. Looks something like that. Now that's the line 8x plus 3y equals 1200. I got the inequality. I want 8x plus 3y to be less than or equal to 1200. We're coming this way. We're going to go to the left of the line there. And these are all the points where 8x plus 3y is less than or equal to 1200. Now the points that satisfy both of these restrictions are the ones in the overlap. Right there in that overlap region. Of course, I have another restriction here. I have that memory restriction. Another restriction means another color. We're going to use green on that one. And I'm going to start off by cleaning up that a little bit. These decimals confuse me. I'm going to multiply through by 5 to get rid of them. And I'll get x plus 4y is less than or equal to 650. And again, I'll start off by graphing the line x plus 4y equals 650. If I put in x equals 0, I'll divide by 4, I'll get 162.5 for y, a little over 160. It's going to be somewhere up here. And I can get the slope, subtract x, divide by 4, I'll have a negative 1/4 x. The slope of this line is going to be negative 1/4. Negative means it's sloping down. Quarter is really close to 0, so it's going to be close to flat. It'll be something like that. Now again, that's where x plus 4y equals 650. I want x plus 4y to be less than or equal to 650. I'm going to come below that line. And that is, this green is the region where I satisfy my memory restriction. Now, of course, I have to pick a value of x and a value of y that satisfies all three of these restrictions. So I need to pick a point that's yellow to satisfy this restriction, red to satisfy that one, and green to satisfy that one. I need the overlap of these three shaded regions. I need another color. I'm going to go ahead and paint that overlap blue. And this is the region where all three of these restrictions overlap. All three of the shaded regions overlap right in here. And this space in here, these are all the points x, y, such that x and y, those values of x and y, satisfy all three of these restrictions. So these are all the possibilities, every single possibility for the number of games and the number of movies I can choose right in this little region. And our goal is to pick the one that wastes the most time. We need to maximize 4x plus 2y. All right, so here's your challenge. I'm going to let you try to do that first. Figure out how to find the point that's in this region, in here, that maximizes the amount of time I get to waste while I'm going to Mars. And once you figure that out, you can check out the next video, Trip to Mars, The Solution.